Hello YouTube, this is Praveen for TechEmpty. In this video, I'll be showing you the method to clean install Windows 11 on an unsupported computer. It is possible by bypassing the registry. No worries, I'll try to guide you better during the entire process till you get Windows 11 on an unsupported hardware. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please hit the red subscribe button down below and hit the bell icon to learn something new. So, without any further ado, let's get started. Before knowing the process, let me show you the system compatibility by running the Microsoft PC Health Checker application. You can get the app from the link provided in the description of this video. After the download, install the Microsoft PC Health Checker app by following the on-screen instructions. Then choose Check Now. As you can see, this PC doesn't meet the basic system requirements to run Windows 11 because of the processor and the TPM module. Let us bypass this restriction to install Windows 11 on an unsupported hardware. First of all, get the Windows 11 ISO image file from the Microsoft website. You can visit the link provided here in the description of this video. Once you are at the download page, head over to the Download Windows 11 Disk Image ISO section, then choose Windows 11 Edition and click on Download. Now choose Product Language, then hit Confirm. Finally, click on the Download button to get the ISO file of Windows 11 to install Windows 11 on an unsupported computer. The file was around 5.2 GB and it will take a while to download based on your internet speed. Once downloaded, save it somewhere safe. The second step is to make a bootable Windows 11 pen drive to install Windows 11 on an unsupported hardware. To do that, go to rufus.ie and you can find the direct link in the description of this video. Once you are at the download page, get the latest version of Rufus tool that will help you to create a bootable Windows 11 USB drive with custom settings. Once you have the Rufus tool, insert the pen drive of at least 8 GB to the computer. Now open the Rufus application, then select the Windows 11 ISO file that we downloaded recently. Make sure to have GPT as a partition scheme and file system as NTFS. Now click on Start and the system will first format the entire pen drive. Make sure not to have any data on the flash drive before performing this step. Choose OK, then Rufus will create a bootable USB drive with Windows 11. When done, close the application. Third step is to create a bypass registry file. To do that, open the notepad and paste this code. You can find this code right here in the description of this video. Now save the file as bypass.org at the safest location. You need to remember the location of where you save it. Fourth step is to change the boot priority. To do that, restart the computer and enter into BIOS settings. You may see the BIOS settings key during the startup. For me, it's delete or F2 key. In here, move to boot tab and make sure to choose the first boot device as your pen drive that we just installed the Windows 11. For me, it's Lexa. Now save and exit the configuration by choosing the right key. For me, it's F10. Fifth step is to install Windows 11 on an unsupported PC. After exiting the boot configuration, you will see the same Windows setup screen. Choose Next, then select Install Now. Now enter the product key if you have one, else choose I don't have a product key. No worries, you can activate the Windows later. Now choose the Windows version and click on Next. There you get the error this PC can't run Windows 11. To fix this, press Shift plus F10 to get the command prompt, then type regedit. Here choose File, then Import, then navigate to the location where you saved the bypass.registry file, then import it. That's it. Close the registry editor and exit the command prompt. Now quit the setup and go through the installation process again. There you go. You will get the license agreement window, then the error screen. Now accept the terms, choose custom install, delete C drive, and the related recovery system and MSR reserved partitions. When you have the unallocated space, choose New, then click on Apply. This step will create new additional partitions and choose newly created primary drive, then click on Next. This will start to install Windows 11 on an unsupported hardware. Once completed, configure the computer like you need. The performance of the PC is pretty good, and here are the device specifications on which we install the Windows 11. Also, make sure to sign into your Microsoft account to get the product activated automatically. That's it for this quick video. I hope you find this video useful. If you do, please hit the like button and consider sharing this video with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos like these. Your contribution is more to us. This is Praveen signing off. I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you.